Blog Talk Radio.
Yeah. Walking in cathedrals with high ceilings, I feel faint. Knowing that their origins is built on the blood of the saints. They on a crash course straight to Hades. Josephus try to tell them, ain't no paradise for these people establishing world rebellion. It's a fixed part in the earth reserved for torment, so judgment. No rest, no water, no food to scorch us. With legions of demons waiting to afflict us for boredoms of eternity. The only fragrance is the sapphire and mercury. Your world is of iniquity, Jesuits. Masons, what makes it more relevant when you're hella bent? They be spacing your television. Programming, how they television. Sacrifice, missing children, erected statues, prolific buildings. Check it for lodges, Czechoslovakian, Bohemian Grove, style glow. How they operate, no remorse, got us lost in the system. Chief demons of exorcism. Many shall say, Lord, Lord, he shall dismiss us. People often perceive evil, not knowing its origin, Prince of Darkness and its people. People often perceive evil, not knowing its origin, Prince of Darkness and its people. People often perceive evil, not knowing its origin, Prince of Darkness and its people. People often perceive evil, not knowing its origin, Prince of Darkness and its people.
Matthew 7 and 22. Many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name? In thy name cast out devils? In thy name done many wonderful works? And then I will profess unto them, I never knew you, depart from me, ye that work iniquity.
No P-O-P-E gon' say the P-O-P-E-O-P-L-E from falling in the deepest of the belly. Scarlet color devils in Revelation, but they can't see. Matthew 23 verse 9, but they can't read. Y'all been tricked by the magic and the alchemy. Who y'all call father, a rocker, knock him off the balcony. Ain't nothing but some wolves among sheep, and they out to eat. But once a liar meet a lion, who becomes the beast? My people on the road to redemption. Once the Father sent the Spirit to come speak, we all listen. Just trying to keep the faith in these hell-like conditions. Not submissive, you'll be in a submission, but we all got a mission. So close to land of milk and honey, we can taste that. Where we build under the Father, you can't break that. Reed is trying to bring Jake back, but the whole world hates that. People often perceive evil, not knowing its origin, Prince of Darkness and its people. People often perceive evil, not knowing its origin, Prince of Darkness and its people. People often perceive evil, not knowing its origin, Prince of Darkness and its people. People often perceive evil, not knowing its origin, Prince of Darkness and its people. People often perceive evil, not knowing this origin, Prince of Darkness and its people. People often perceive evil, not knowing this origin, Prince of Darkness and its people. People often perceive evil.
And it's the music of Castanario, P-O-P-E, featuring John Boyd. Well, shalom, Israel, and to everyone else, good evening, good afternoon, good morning to you and yours, wherever you are on this world's wide web. You're listening to CSI, Crime Scene Investigation, where we look into the books that were deleted from our history book, the Bible. We're looking into the book of Jubilee. Today, chapter 20, as we make up from last week, as we get ready to explore the book of Jubilee, chapter 20. If you'd like to join in on our show conversation while we are here live, you can hit us up at 347-205-9279 or join us right there in the chat room at blogtalkradio.com/men empower. Thank you always for listening to us in the archives right there at Blog Talk Radio, as well as on YouTube via Hebrews Truth and Consequence, as well as Jude Up. Subscribe to those information portals on YouTube.com. And we will get started momentarily. Just want to remind you again, also, our regular schedule, summer schedule, is Wednesday, Thursday, and Saturday. Wednesday is CSI, and on Thursday is Let's Talk, and followed by the number one show of Hebrews Truth Music, Saturday Night Gospel Jam, with your host, Brother Malachi, as well as Sister Fire Harris, very fabulous co-host from the Fort Worth Metroplex area right here in the United States of America, a.k.a. Babylon. Don't forget, you can always hit us when we're not live at 504-484-9388. And you can hit us up at our email address is menempoweredtoprosper@yahoo.com. And you can always follow along with us to find out what's going on at Men Empowered, at Men Empowered, at Twitter.com. And if you are a photo fanatic, follow along with us at Men Empowered 2 at Instagram.com. We'll be right back and getting started right after this music break.
Yeah.
Welcome back to CSI Crime Scene Investigation. It's the music of Richard Shepherd Jr. right here on CSI. Okay, let's get started. Go ahead and get started in the Book of Jubilees, Chapter 20. The Book of Jubilees, Chapter 20. And in the 42nd Jubilee, in the first year of the 70th week, Abraham called Ishmael and his 12 sons, and Isaac and his 2 sons, and the 6th son of Keturah and their sons. And he commanded them that they should observe the way of the Most High, that they should work righteously and love each his neighbor, and amongst all men, that they should each so walk with regard to them as to do judgment and righteousness on the earth, that they should circumcise their sons according to the covenant which he had made with them, and not deviate to the right hand or to the left of all the paths which the Most High had commanded us, and that we should keep ourselves from all fornication and uncleanness, and renounce from amongst us all fornication and uncleanness. And if any woman or maid commit fornication among you, burn her with fire, and let them not commit fornication with her after their eyes and their hearts. And let them not take to themselves wives from the daughters of Canaan, for the seed of Canaan will be rooted out of the land. Judgment of the giants and the judgment of the Sodomites. And they had been judged on account of their wickedness, and had died on account of their fornication and uncleanness and mutual corruption through fornication. And guard yourself from all fornication and uncleanness, and from all pollution of sin, lest ye make our name a curse and your whole life a hissing. And all your sons to be destroyed by the sword, and ye become accursed like Sodom, and all your remnant as the sons of Gomorrah. I implore you, my sons, love the Most High of heaven, and cleave ye to all his commandments, and walk not after their cleanness, and make not for yourself molten or graven gods. You see this right here, molten or graven gods, like after, elaborating a little bit, like after the Israelites, when they came out, what did they make? They made a molten calf, and we know the god of that calf's name was Yahweh. A molten calf, and you can see a lot of molten items, far as idols, in America today with all the statues. You can even go on Wall Street, you will see that molten calf, whether it's made of gold or made of clay. It is a molten calf. You call it like the bull of Marilyn Lynch. But it is the same. It is the same. It is represented by an idol. Okay, moving on. And walk not after their idols and after their uncleanness, and make not for yourselves molten or graven gods, for they are vanity, and there is no in them. For they are work of men's hands, and all who trust in them trust in nothing. Serve them not, nor worship them, but serve ye the Most High God, and worship him continually, and hope for his countenance always, and work up righteousness and righteousness, and work up righteous and righteousness before him. Now, you know, also, you can look at most of your religious organizations around the world is represented by some form of a type of idol or some type of stone carved into a symbol or such. And we're not going to go through all those religions, but you all kind of know exactly what I'm talking about when you see things such as Buddhists, you know, the little small figurine that is real small, that represents that particular religion and so on. Just like in Christianity, Christianity is represented with the cross and so on and so on. All right, now, that he may have pleasure in you and grant you his mercy and send rain upon you morning and evening and bless all your works which ye have wrought upon the earth and bless thy bread and thy water and bless the fruit of thy womb and the fruit of thy land and the herds of thy cattle and the flock of the sheep and ye shall be a blessing on the earth, and all nations, plural, nations of the earth will desire you, and bless your sons in my name, that they may be blessed as I am. Moving on to verse number 11, still in chapter 20. I believe we're going to go far as chapter 21. Let's see how far we can go. And he gave to Ishmael and to his sons and to the sons of Keturah gifts and sent them away from Isaac his son, and he gave everything to Isaac his son and Ishmael and his sons, and the sons of Keturah and their sons went together and dwelt from Paran to the entering in of Babylon in all the land which is toward the east facing the desert. And these mingle with each other, and their Arabs and Ishmaelites. Okay. As you can see in the book of Jasher, we remember that Abraham was kind of disappointed with Ishmael's wife, I believe his first wife, and Ishmael put that particular wife away because she was not obeying the commandments far as Hebrew laws. And then his second wife, I believe, came into the favor of Abraham when Abraham paid Ishmael a visit again. And we see where he was pleased with this wife as well as the mannerism of his children. You all know that Ishmael and his descendants follow the Hebrew law way before Muhammad came in on the scene. Even though Ishmael was not the chosen, but Ishmael knew the commandments and tried to get all his children to follow after the Hebrew way of life, the Hebrew law, way before Islam the scene. Okay, now you can check that out in the book of Jasher. All right, let's go to chapter 21 of the book of Jubilees. And in the sixth year of the seventh week of this Jubilee, Abraham called Isaac his son and commanded him, saying, I am become old and know not the day of my life, my death, and am full of my days. And behold, I am 175 years old, and throughout all the days of my life, I have remembered the Most High, and sought with all my heart to do his will and to walk uprightly in all his ways. My soul has hated idols. You remember the account of Abraham in the book of Genesis, as well as in the book of Jasher, what he did with those idols, because he had the understanding of what idols were, because he was taught under Noah and Shem. given my heart and spirit that I might observe to do, and that's found in the book of Joshua, and that I might observe to do the will of him who created me. For he is the living God, and he is holy and faithful, and he is righteous beyond all. And there is with him no accepting of men's persons and no accepting of gifts. For God, the Most High, is righteous and executed judgment on all those who transgress his commandments and despise his covenant. And do thou, my son, observe his commandments and his ordinances and his judgment, and walk not after the abominations and after the graven images and to the molten images, and eat no blood at all of animals or cattle or of any birds which flies in the heavens. And if thou dost slay a victim in as an acceptable peace offering, slay ye it and pour out its blood upon the altar, and all the fat of the offering offer on the altar with fine flour, and the meat offering mingle with oil, with its drink offering. Offer them all together on the altar of burnt offerings. It is a sweet savor before the Most High. Now you all remember that Esau, the reason why Esau did not get the inheritance of the Most High, because Esau despised the commandments. He kept not the commandments. As you can see in other teachings that we had in the other books, I believe that was in, an earlier edition of the Book of Jubilees. We had talked about it in some area that we had. I think it was Jubilees, that because Esau did not want to obey the commandments, he did not want to eat meat well done, cook well. He always wanted everything bloody. And you can see this characteristic in his descendants today, the Caucasians. The Caucasians, not all of them, love to eat their meat rare or medium rare. And like I gave you the example of some of my co-workers when I was in the restaurant industry, only wanted to cook his meat 15 seconds on each side and then put it on a plate, take it, and he wanted to eat it. That's rare. That right there is against the commandments of the Most High. You do not eat any animal that way. You cook it all the way, because you know life is in the blood, and we're not to do that according to Leviticus. All right, moving on in Jubilees in 21, and thou wilt offer the fat of the sacrifice of thanks offerings on the fire which is upon the altar, and the fat which is on the belly, and all the fat on the inwards and the two kidneys, and all the fat that is upon them, and upon the loins and liver thou shalt remove, together with the kidneys, and offer all these for a sweet savor acceptable before the Most High. Offering for a sweet savor. The bread of the offering upon the Most High, and eat its meat on that day and on the second day, and let not the sun on the second day go down upon it till it is eaten, and let nothing be left over for the third day, for it is not acceptable, and let it no longer be eaten. And all who eat thereof will bring sin upon themselves, for thus I have found it written in the book of my forefathers, and in the words of Enoch, and in the words of Noah, and on all thy obligations, obtations, thou shalt stew salt, and let not the salt of the covenant be lacking in all. day up as regard the woods of the sacrifice. Beware lest thou bring other wood for the altar in addition to these: cypress, bay, almond, fir, pine, cedar, saving, fig, olive, myrit, laurel, aspalus, and all these kinds of wood lay upon the altar under the sacrifice, such as have been tested as to their appearance, and do not lay any split or dark wood, but hard and clean without fault, a sound and new growth, and do not lay thereon old wood, for it is fragrance is gone, for there is no longer fragrance in it as before. Besides these kinds of wood, there is none other than thou shall place on the altar, for the fragrance is despised, and the smell of this fragrance goes not up to heaven. Observe this commandment and do it, my son, that thou mayest be upright in thy deeds, and at all times be clean in thy body, and wash thyself with water before thou approachest to offer on the altar, and wash thy hands and thy feet before thou drawest near to the altar, and when thou art done sacrificing, wash again thy hands and thy feet, and let no blood appear upon you, nor upon your clothes. Be on thy guard, my son, against blood. Be on thy guard exceedingly. Cover it with dust, and do not eat any blood, for it is the soul. Eat no blood whatever, and take no gifts for the blood of man. Then we just talk about a minute or so ago about Esau. Lest it be shed with purity, for it is the blood that is shed that caused the earth to sin, and the earth cannot be cleansed from the blood of man save by the blood of him who shed it. And take no present or gift for the blood of man, blood for blood, that thou mayest be acceptable before the Most High God. For he is the defense of the good, and that thou mayest preserve from all evil, and that he may save thee from every kind of death. See, my son, that all the works of the children of men are sin and wickedness, and all their deeds are uncleanness and abomination and a pollution, and there is no righteous with them. Verse 22, beware lest thou shouldest walk in their ways and tread in their path, and sin unto death before the Most High God. Else he will hide his face from thee and give thee back into the hands of thy transgression, and root thee out of the land, and thy seed likewise from under heaven, and thy seed and thy name and thy seed shall perish from the whole earth. Verse 23, turn away all their deeds and all their uncleanness, and observe the ordinance of the Most High God, and do his will, and be upright in all things. 24, and he will bless thee in all thy deeds, and will raise up from thee a plant of righteousness through all the earth, throughout all generations of the earth. And my name and thy name shall not be forgotten under heaven forever. Go, my son, in peace. May the Most High God, may God and thy God strengthen thee to do his will. And may he bless all thy seed and the residue of thy seed for the generations forever with all righteous blessings, that thou mayest be a blessing on all the earth. And he went out from him rejoicing. Now we're going to stop right here, and on CSI on tomorrow, we're going to pick back up on chapter 22. Chapter 22, We're going to get into it, and we're going to pick that back up. So, Brother Malachi, I am going to, and I am going to sign off right now, and I will see you all on tomorrow night's show on Wednesday at 10 p.m. Central Standard Time. As we leave you with Brother Maverick's song, They Lie, we will see you on the show tomorrow night at 10 p.m. on CSI, Crime Scene Investigation, the Book of Jubilees, Chapter 22. Shalom.
The people in Israel right now are not Jews. They're Khazars. Your true Druze, or your true Yehudim, are the so-called black person, or African-American, as you like to call them sometimes. They're not African at all. They're the true Jews. They're the true Hebrews that were brought over here on ships, which the scriptures mention.
Is the greatest. People never known to me and formed the shape. Who is the king and all these religious paintings? Change the Lord's name and gave it from the facelift. Who masquerading, perpetrating the nation, making the people famous, pushing abomination to entertainment, murdering, maiming, you name it, heinous, reinous, gayness. Who run the bank then? Where are the banquets? Who charged the interest on this? Who needs the pay print? I'm not a blasphemy spoken. Who's saying it? Whole world going to hell when who making it? Who off the anguish, letting loose the strangers? Agendas on the people of earth, claiming it's painless. It's war everywhere. Who is the gain in it? It costs a lot of bread. Who's paying it?
I know thy poverty, thy rights, and thy situation.
Yeah, we know. Yeah, we know who you are.
Claim to be Jews and are not. But all the sinners I have saved.
Most of the tribe of Judah was still 12,000.
I know the blasphemy of those, but thou art great.
From the tribe of Reuben was still 12,000.
Claim to be Jews and are not. But all the sinners I have saved.
Straight up saved. Who really is? Yeah, who really? So who really shaved? Practices the crazy. Perform information. No woman the baby. Who ain't did no work? Who really lazy? And gained everything. The old through debt and slavery. Who think they bigger than God? They can't escape it. We're even crazy, not even occasionally. But love the spirit of evil, think it's amazing. Not about the ignorance either, they know they traded him. Blatantly forsaken him, didn't want to stay with him. Sold the birthright for a bloody raw plate of meat. Gave it to say I beat, and stayed away from me. Committed and dedicated to killing Jacob's seed. Separation, please, it's all the same to me. Holocaust, who financed Hitler's infantry? There's only one people that's faking the name, some one. It's only one people had all that pain.
I know thy poverty, thy rights, and thy situation.
You rich, though, Israel, you
claim to be Jews and are not, but all the sinners I have saved.
From the tribe of Gad was still 12,000.
I know the blasphemy of those, but thou art rich.
From the tribe of Asher was still 12,000.
Claim to be Jews and are not. But
the tribe are not a colleague, but still